What's up, everybody? My name is Adav, and in this video, we'll talk about a very common error when working with pods in Kubernetes, the image pull backoff error. Now, I work at Datree, and we provide a policy enforcement solution for preventing misconfigurations and errors in Kubernetes manifest files. And at Datree, we see many users encountering various errors, and one of the most common ones is this image pull backoff error. So in this video, we will understand what causes this error, what this error means, and how to fix it. So let's get started. Image pull backoff is an error state that occurs when a pod fails to start up due to some issue it has with pulling the image that is associated with it. Now, there are two main reasons for that. The first reason is a misconfiguration in the path, in some part of the path. So let's take a look and see what that looks like. Here we have a demo deployment file that specifies one pod with a container taking the image from this path. Now, generally, an image path is comprised of three parts. The first part is the registry, in this case, the Google container registry. The second part is the name of the repository within that registry. And the third part is the image itself, comprised of the image name and the tag. So let's see what happens when one of these is misconfigured. We'll start with the image name. So in this case, the registry exists and is valid, the repo exists and is valid, but this is an invalid name of an image, so we can expect to get an error. So let's go ahead and apply this file. We can see that our deployment was created. And now we can run kubectl get pods in this namespace to see how our pod is doing. Okay, so right away we see that we get the error image pullback error. And we can further inspect this pod to see what the specific error message is. So we do that by running kubectl describe pod and the name of the pod. And of course, specify our namespace. So here is the error message that we get from kubectl. And we can see that it's telling us that it failed to fetch version 1.0 from our request. Now, this can be a bit misleading because from this error message, we might understand that the mistake was in our tag, meaning that 1.0 is wrong and maybe 2.0 is a valid image. But we know that in our case, the image name itself is wrong. So the important thing to take away from this is that if you encounter this error message, that means that you either have a mistake in your tag or in your name. So now let's see what happens when we have a misconfigured repository name. So let's update our YAML. And now we'll use this image path. In this path, the registry is the same, still valid, but the repository samples is invalid, doesn't exist. So let's see what happens. First, let's delete our old deployment and apply it again. And now let's take a look at our pods and we can see that we get the same error state again. Let's inspect our pod again. So we run kubectl describe pod with its name and the namespace. Okay, so here we see that the error message is a bit clearer, right? Because we can see the error is unknown, project samples not found or deleted. So this error message is actually pointing us to our repository name, which is samples, and we know that the mistake is probably there. Great, now let's see what we get when we have a misconfigured registry name. So let's delete this. And let's update our image path once again. So in this path, the repo and the image name are both valid, but the registry doesn't exist. Let's see. We'll apply our YAML again. Take a look at our pods again. And again, image pull back off, but we can expect a different message. Okay, so indeed we have a different message. And this one is also quite clear because we can see that the lookup for the registry we specified failed with the explanation of no such host. So when we see this, we can assume we either have some connectivity error to the registry, or more likely we have some typo or misconfiguration in our registry name. So now that we know what to expect when each part of our path is misconfigured, here's a quick tip for you. So before you attempt to push your pod into your cluster and specifying the image for it, what you can do is try to pull the image locally first. How would that look? You can use something like Docker to pull your image. And I would start by pulling it using a generic tag, like latest. So you would specify your registry, repo, and image, just like we saw before, and use latest. Now, if this works for you, then that means that your path is valid, all components are valid, and the next thing you should do is attempt to change latest with your desired image tag. So for instance, let's say 1.0.1. Now you run this still locally, and if this fails, then you know that you have an issue with your tag, right? Because the rest of the path is valid. And if this works, when you pull locally using Docker pull, but it fails when you try to use it in your YAML, then you know that you probably have an access configuration issue or some access issue between your pod and the registry that you're trying to pull from. And that brings us to the second reason why this error occurs, and that is an authentication issue with your registry. Instead of using a public registry, what many users and companies do is they use a private registry to host their images. That way, they can do their own verification for the images and make sure that they know exactly what each repository contains. Now, when you try to pull an image via your pod from a private registry, if you're not authenticated with the registry, you will also get the image pullback error. So let's see an example of this using JFrog, which, among other cool things, provides a private container registry. So let's update our YAML. And this is my JFrog server that contains a demo image that we can use to see what kind of error we get. So let's delete our deployment and apply it once again. And if we take a look at our pods, we can see that, again, we get the same error state. Let's describe the pod once again. Okay, so now the error is completely different, and we see that it's an authentication issue. So we can understand from this that this is failing because we are not authenticated with the repo that we're trying to pull from. To fix this, we need to give our pods access to the registry. Now we do that in two simple steps. First, we need to create a Kubernetes secret. This is the command we used, kubectl create secret, and we need to provide it some details. So we need to provide our server that we want to authenticate to, our username, our password, and our email. And of course, here we specify the namespace that we want the secret to be created in. So as you can see, reg secret was created. Step one is complete. The next thing we need to do is to tell Kubernetes to use this new secret when the pods in this namespace request access to the registry. So we do that by editing the default service account that comes with each namespace. So we can run this command, kubectl edit, and we're editing the service account of the demo NS namespace. This will bring us into the service account resource itself. And what we need to do here is add the following lines. So we can add that right here. And this is actually telling this namespace that whenever a pod attempts to pull an image, then it has the necessary credentials that it needs to access this registry. So let's save this. Now let's go back and take a look at our pod. So if we run get pods again, great, our pod is now running. Now, any other pod that we will create in this namespace will also have access to this registry. So there you have it. Those are the main causes and fixes for this error. Now, generally speaking, it's always better to prevent your mistakes than to fix them, right? One way to do that is to use the tree. So the tree allows you to scan your Kubernetes manifest files and detect any misconfigurations or errors in them very early in your coding process, right? Either while you're coding or as part of your CI before you integrate your code. Now, the tree comes with a bunch of built-in rules that enforce some best practices in working with Kubernetes, but it also allows you to create your own custom rules. And with these custom rules, you can enforce any policy that suits your needs. So let's take a look how that could help us in this case. Going back to our deployment file, the image path we used uses this registry to get the image from. Now, our custom rule can enforce that all the images under all containers come from this registry, right? So we can check the value of the image key and ensure that it begins with this string. That way we know that all images are coming from our private registry and they're safe to use. So I hope this video cleared some things up for you regarding this error. And thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.